leaked talks in Congress, and the cyber attack on U.S. government. Want to discuss and get her outlook on all of it? We are now joined by Senator Marsha Blackburn of Tennessee. Hi, Senator. Great to have you on.
Hi. How are you? Good to be with you today.
I'm doing well. Thank you so much for being on here today. It's such a pleasure. And I just want to get to this straight ahead. So much has been going on, especially in Capitol Hill. We saw you talking just recently. Let's start with this. How have stimulus negotiations been going on thus far?
The negotiations are taking place. I was on the floor earlier today and talked a little bit about what has transpired in July, in September, in October, November, December. Republicans have taken relief bills to the floor of the Senate, and every single time the Democrats have voted no. And they don't want to solve this problem. And here we are. It is Christmas week. We're hearing from businesses that are really suffering. People need relief. They want to see Congress take an action. But the Democrats have felt that it benefited them not to take that action and provide that relief. So consistently, they have rejected these proposals. They have put politics ahead of people. They are trying to use this bill to push their socialist agenda. And they just have not shown the willingness to negotiate in good faith.
Well, I got to press you on this one, but will we see a bill passed by Monday?
I don't know the answer to that. Mitch McConnell has said we're not going to leave until there is a bill that is passed, but we'll see where it goes.
And on to another major headline this week, a cyber attack on the U.S. President Trump tweeted this morning that the attack is not what the fake news media is making it out to be. And also China saying that, you know, Russia may have not been behind it, rather China, as I just mentioned previously. Senator, you've been a vocal critic on China, even tweeting a video yesterday that the Chinese Communist Party is trying to use every avenue for propaganda and to spy on the American people. Why is the president pointing to China despite what other intel officials are saying?
What we know is that China, Russia, Iran, and North Korea are indeed the new axis of evil. China is the innovators. Russia likes to do the bankrolling of these things. And implementers, you've got Iran and North Korea with plenty of people that like to implement things that are going to tear down the U.S. The cyber attack was initiated from what we understand and what Intel is telling us. It did come through the SVR, the Russian online technology spy group, and it did go through SolarWinds and did impact the U.S. government and many of the corporations here in the U.S.
All right, and before we move on to the topic of conservative women, is there anything else that you would like to add on the topic of China?
China is going to be a big topic in 2021. And when we talk about the Georgia Senate races, why is it so important we hold the Senate? Is because we're never going to get to the bottom of what happened with Biden Incorporated, Hunter Biden, Eric Swalwell, Dianne Feinstein and her driver of 20 years, everybody closely involved with China, and of course in the Swalwell and Feinstein cases, the staff members or the close relationship, cozy relationship that were there with spies. People want answers to those questions. They want to know what kind of business Hunter Biden actually did with the Chinese Communist Party owned entities. And of course, in Georgia, you also have a candidate, John Ossoff, who has worked for a media company that is owned in part by the Chinese Communist Party, which is something I understand has caused people in Georgia to have concern over a cozy relationship with the Chinese Communist Party.